Today we are going to look at pressure in liquids. This is Kisembo Academy and thanks for tuning in. Before we deal with calculations relating to pressure in liquids, we are going to first derive how the formula for this pressure in liquids is derived. Now, from the beginning, we said that pressure, by definition, is the force acting normally per unit area. And we also agreed that the formula, therefore, is pressure is going to be equal to force over area. So now let's go ahead and try and find out how to do. So we are going to use that exact formula to help us derive pressure in liquids. Now, right here, we are having a can. This can is having water. Now, we are having a cross-sectional area A right there, this top surface of the water. When you look in there, that is cross-sectional area A. Now, this water column that is in a measuring cylinder is definitely having weight. Is definitely having weight, and this weight, therefore, is exerting a certain pressure at the bottom of this can. So, pressure exerted by this water is force over area. Now, the force that is being exerted by this water is definitely its weight. And if it's its weight, the force is going to be equal to mass times gravity. So it's the mass times the gravity of the water. Divide that by the area. Now the area, this is the cross-sectional area. So now from mass, we know that mass is going to be equal to density times volume. So our next step is going to be the density times volume. This is coming from the M right here. So it's density times volume, then times the gravity. Divide that by area. Now from this step, we know we expand the volume. The volume of this water, this is a cylinder. So because it is a circular cylinder, it's going to be this cross-sectional area, which is pi r squared divided by h. But the cylinder is not always going to be circular. The cylinder can always be, it can be a square cylinder, it can have a different shape. So in general terms, to find the volume of this kind of cylinder, it's going to be the cross-sectional area, which is A, multiply that by the height. So in a way, you're finding the volume of the water. So it means that here it's going to be, the volume is going to be cross-sectional area, which we have called A, times the height, which is H. This is what is substituting for V. Then we still have the density right there and the gravity. And all this is divided by A in that step. So of course, this at this stage, we can't go any further than this. So this A cancels with that A, and when that A cancels with that A, you remain with density times the height times the gravity. And this definitely is how we arrive to that. P is equal to H rho g, which is height times density times gravity. This is the pressure in liquids. Now, height is always supposed to be in meters, because the SI unit for pressure is newtons per meter squared. For us to get this newton per meter squared means that our height is supposed to be in meters. Our density is supposed to be in kilograms per meter squared. Then definitely, of course, our gravity is in meters per second squared. Now here, I'm telling us to calculate the pressure at a point 5 meters below the surface of a freshwater of density that. This is what they mean. That they want us to find the pressure at a point 5 meters below the surface of water. Now, if this is the point they are talking about, it is 5 meters below the surface. So this is the surface of the water. That's the water. So they want to find the pressure at this point that is 5 meters below the surface. So to find pressure, it's going to be height times density times gravity, just like we had previously derived. So the height is 5 meters times the density. Now, they're telling us the density of the water is 1,000. So it's going to be times 1,000 times the gravity, which is 10. So our answer is going to definitely be 50,000 newtons per meter squared. That's our answer. Remember, I said that the height is supposed to be in meters. If it is not in meters, they've given you this figure in centimeters or any other funny digits, any other funny units. Convert it first to meters. The air density is supposed to be in kilogram per meter cubed, and our gravity is in meters per second squared. Now, should you calculate this now, this in such a way that the units are not SI unit. It means that the final answer you will be getting will not qualify to be in newtons per meter squared, but it will be in terms of other units. Let's look at the second example. They're telling us that calculate the pressure at a point of 5 meters below the surface of salt water whose density is that. So the sketch is the same as this one. It's still, they want us to find this, but now here we're dealing with salty water. So meaning that pressure here is going to be height times density times gravity. The height is still 5 meters because it's a general thing. So it's going to be 5 meters. Multiply that by the density. Now, according to this, the density they've given us is 1029 kilograms per meters cubed. Multiply that by the gravity, which is 10. And definitely when you multiply that, you end up with 51. This is in newtons per meter squared. A paraffin reservoir tank contains paraffin to a depth of 5 meters. What is the pressure at the base of the reservoir? Density of paraffin is 800 kilograms per meter cubed. Same semantics. This is a paraffin reservoir tank. It's containing paraffin to a depth of 5 meters. So it has 5 meters. It's all this is paraffin. And they've told us that the density of the paraffin is 800 kilograms per meter cubed. So our paraffin, the pressure is going to be the height times the density times the gravity. We know that the height here is 5 meters times the density, which is going to be 800 kilograms per meter cubed according to our question. Multiply that by the gravity, which is 10. And definitely our answer there is going to be 40,000. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. For more of these videos, I encourage you to simply subscribe. And please remember to share this video. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rwanga Kuramya.